The next topic that we want to deep dive is volumes. We have looked at containers, and containers are ephemeral. They come and go. The pods are spin up, they die, and all the data stored inside pod or container goes along with that. What we need is persistent storage as well. Not all applications are stateless. We have a lot of data to store. We need temporary storage. We need storage for sharing across different applications. We need database storage so that we can persist for long-lived data. All that is real need in enterprise application. We need some solution for persistent storage. In Kubernetes, we have many types of volumes available, which is different types of persistent available for pods. The first type is empty directory. The second type is host path. The third type, using the cloud service provider persistent storage, elastic block storage from AWS, persistent disk from GCE, and Azure disk. Also, if you have network file storage on-prem, you can use that as well. All this is supported in Kubernetes. To learn more about many other types of volumes, you can go to Kubernetes documentation. Let's look at the first type, which is empty directory. The name suggests this always starts as empty directory, means no data at the start. It is created when the pod gets created and mounted and accessible across all the containers in the pod. It helps to share data across different containers. You remember we have seen the two container example where we want to share a log file from written from a web app to log collector agent. This is a classical use case for that. How to specify empty directory volume for your pod? Simple. Within the spec tag of your descriptor YAML, there is an option where you can specify volumes. You give the name to the volume and specify what type of volume you want to have. Here, empty directory and no parameters to it. Once the volume is created at the pod level, you have to map it as volume mount inside your container. So the name of volume mount is going to match with the name of your volume name that you have defined at the top. And the mount path is the path which will be mounted inside your container. So the name matches with the name of the volume that you have created. And that's how, so you can have multiple volumes also created here and assigned and mounted at the different mount path. Let's look at the demo quickly. If you remember, we have seen this file when we looked at the multi-container demo. I have a pod named empty directory, creating a volume, which is type empty directory. Name of the volume is HTML. I have two containers, C1 and C2. I'm mapping the HTML volume to mount path default directory for Nginx to serve the content. And another pod, which is just writing to this index.html appending date every 5 seconds. So let's run this. Have my pod created. There are two containers. I got my pod running. Now I want to get inside the pod. So I'm getting inside C1, container one. You can just do mount grep HTML. See, right, three. You can just do quickly tail minus F. index.html. I open another terminal, connect to the second container, C2. Again, check my mount path. I do tail minus F slash HTML slash index.html. You see, both the containers are sharing the same volume, and changes from one container is getting reflected into another container. That's how you can have a shared mount path between two containers using empty directory. Remember, the timestamp that we have seen is in the 10:31 UTC. Okay. Stop this. We'll exit from here. We'll exit from here. I'm going to delete the pod. Pod is getting terminated. I'm going to recreate the pod. Get into the first pod again. Check the mount path. Going to tail on the file. You notice that the number showing up from 10:34. The last one was here, 10:32. If I go here in the C2, if I do tail minus f slash html slash index.html, again I'll see the same file. However, it was cleared when pod got restarted. Empty directory is good option to share volume between two containers, and data is lost when pod goes down. The next volume type is host path. As the name suggested, this volume type shares the storage from the backing node on which the pod is running. Directory is mounted inside your container, which is a directory on your host machine, worker node. Data is retained on the node even after the pod is. The data is not available if the pod is scheduled on the another node. So when you restart the pod, and if this pod comes up on the same node, the same host path is mounted and we are good. And data cannot be saved if node crashes. To specify host path in your descriptor YAML, what you have to do is, instead of empty directory, you specify type as host path and give the path of your backing node, which is your worker node. This directory should exist on the worker node, and you mount the directory into container in the exact same way with the name matching to the name of the volume here. The only difference is host path. This type of volume is a very good option to share data across pods. So if you have same host path specified in two different pods connected to the same backing node, then you can have the data shared from one pod to another pod as well. However, remember that the data can be shared only if both the pods are running on the same node. One pod from node one cannot share data to another pod on node two. And there are some special use cases where this is very handy. Let's see the demo of host path. So I'm using the same exact two container configuration and same Nginx running in container one, container two, writing the date into index.html file. The only difference is, instead of empty directory, I'm using the host path, which is home vagrant Nginx HTML.
Let's deploy the host path pod. Let's describe the pod, what's going on. Directory does not exist because the pod is scheduled on Kubernetes node 1. Let's go and create the directory. Let's delete the pod. Redeploy host path. So my pod is running now on Kubernetes node 2. Let's go and see the file there. I'm logging into the node k8s node 2. I have a file which is created just now, index.html. So you notice, just started printing the date and time into the index.html file. Let me go and create another file on my vagrant box. Okay. Since this directory is mapped inside container, this is visible in container as well. To access this file, I'll do the port forwarding. If you see the source, you'll see that the date is getting printed. If I refresh, you'll see the new entries are coming up. Now, if I go and try to access test.html, should see the test.html as well. Let me delete the pod. Okay, pod is deleted. Let's go and see the file exists or not, right? I see both the files are still there. Now let me recreate pod. Pod moved to node 1. Okay, that's the tricky bit here. The directory is there. I've created directory on all machines. However, I'll not have the test.html file there. File is created just now, index.html. Just 4 entries, right? Recent 4 entries. If your pod gets deployed to another node, you lose the data as the data is stored into the previous node. And if I do a port forwarding and try to hit this URL, I'll get 404 found. And I try to reload this page, I'll get the new entries that I have. We stop the pod again. And I try to recreate the pod again. So now this time it went to KTS node 2. So we will see the previous data that we had there. Running. Let's do a quick port forwarding. So if you notice, the previous data is there and the new date time is getting appended now. If I go here, you'll find the test.html. So in short, host path works fine and there are specific use case of the host paths. As I said before, you can share the data from one pod to another pod. And when we learn about daemon sets and all that, you'll be able to understand some use cases where this type of volumes are very useful.
The next exercise is exercise 7. So if you notice, in the previous run, we had MongoDB, which is running as a standard pod. If pod goes down, all the data is lost. In this exercise, what we are going to do is, we are going to make our MongoDB data persist on your node using host path. So even if your MongoDB pod goes down and comes up again, it will reconnect and use the same host path where the actual data is stored. MongoDB data inside your MongoDB container is stored in the path /data/db. So if you mount any directory from your worker node, which is Minikube, to your /data/db directory inside your MongoDB container, it should be good. Once you have set up this, delete and recreate MongoDB pod and see that you have not lost the data. That's your exercise number 7.